In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brother and sister, warm greetings from the Carmelite Fathers, and welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's gospel. It's the 8th of April, Monday of the 5th week of Lent. The Holy Gospel according to John, chapter 8, verses 12 to 20. At that time, Jesus spoke to the Pharisees, saying, "I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." The Pharisees then said to him, "You are bearing witness to yourself. Your testimony is not true." Jesus answered, "Even if I do bear witness to myself, my testimony is true. For I know where I have come from and where I am going. But you do not know where I come or where I am going. You judge according to the flesh. I judge no one. Yet even if I do judge, my judgment is true. For it is not I alone that judge, but I and he who sent me. In your law it is written that the testimony of two men is true. I bear witness to myself, and the Father who sent me bears witness to me." They said to him, "Therefore, where is your Father?" Jesus answered, "You know neither me nor my Father. If you knew me, you would know my Father also." These words he spoke in the treasury, as he taught in the temple. But no one arrested him because his hour had not yet come. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus, my dear friends, has been described in John's Gospel as light many times. In the opening chapter itself, John writes, "In him was life, and that life was the light of men." Chapter 1, verse 4. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. In chapter 3, John writes, "And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and men loved darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil." Their deeds were evil. In today's gospel, Jesus proclaims, "I am the light of the world." As the Feast of the Tabernacles, on the first night of the feast, after the sunset, two great lamps were lighted in the courts of the temple, And these were said to have cast their light over every quarter of the city. The lamps reminded them of the pillar of cloud and fire that accompanied the people in their wanderings in the desert. It kept the Jewish people from being attacked and guided them through the wilderness. It is possible that Jesus was making reference to the miraculous cloud when he claimed to be the light of the world. The cloud symbolized God's presence with the people. But the cloud of God's glory that filled the Holy of Holies of the temple before which Jesus was standing had departed from Israel. Amidst this background, Jesus cries out, "I am the light of the world. I am the light of the world." He is indirectly saying that he is that cloud, the presence of God among the people. In him, God was again with his people. He would not only protect them, but would give them guidance. But he is light for those who are willing to follow him. Jesus is light for those who are willing to follow him. Jesus said, "He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." In John, following Christ is almost synonymous with believing in Christ. So walking or following Christ is believing in Christ. Jesus declares, "I have come as a light into the world, that whoever believes in me may not remain in darkness. I have come as a light into the world, that whoever believes in me may not remain in darkness." What do you want now? The light or the darkness? Let us pray. My dear friends, as we find in the Bible diary today, it's the death anniversary of Elias Rodriguez from Mudubelle, Henry D'Souza from Mumbai. May the Lord grant them eternal rest. We also remember all your intentions, my dear friends. May God bless you all. We also remember all our benefactors, our well-wishers, people of goodwill, those who have contributed to the education fund, those of you who have taken our seminarians as your spiritual sons, those who have sponsored the pages of Bible Diary. Lord, make us joyful followers of Christ the light, to avoid walking in darkness. Amen. Have a great week, my dear friends. May God bless all that you are going to do. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear friends, don't forget to share this audio with your friends and contacts. This is Father Stephen Pereira, Carmelite priest. If you have any prayer requests, feedback on the audio, or for any communication, you can WhatsApp me on my number 94812-63229. 94812-63229. My dear friends, there is going to be a vocation camp for all those boys who are interested to join the Carmelite order at Infant Jesus Shrine, Mangalore, beginning tomorrow, that is 9th of April, in the evening, then going up to 11th of April, that is Thursday, till noon. So I request all those boys who are interested, those who are studying in 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th, are most welcome to participate in this vocation camp. And also I request parents to encourage their children to come for this camp. And rest of you, my dear friends, please keep all these boys in your prayers. And as I told you, you are also welcome to adopt seminarians if you have no priest from your family. And if you would like to have one, you are most welcome. You can contact me. I am Father Stephen Pereira and my number is 94812-63229. 94812-63229. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.